You are likely familiar with using service accounts managed at the domain level to run some PI applications, like PI Buffer Subsystem, and using Windows Integrated Security to authenticate those applications to the PI Data Archive using mappings. If you are using PI API 2016 for Windows Integrated Security, you may even be doing this for API connections such as PI interfaces. This was all possible because the interface and PI Data Archive are in the same domain. An Active Directory manages the user and service accounts across the domain, with their associated passwords. However, what happens when your interface is in a workgroup, but you still want to take advantage of the benefits of Windows Integrated Security and PI API for Windows Integrated Security? The interface node doesn't recognize the domain users or service accounts. And if you set up local accounts on the workgroup machine for your users and services, they won't be recognized by machines on the domain. So you won't be able to authenticate to the PI Data Archive using Windows Integrated Security. And since security is a top concern, we want to avoid 2+ trusts. The solution is Windows Credential Manager, which lets us store domain credentials on a workgroup node and link them to local accounts. This video goes through linking these accounts. In addition to setting up these links, we will verify connection information on the PI Data Archive for the user, buffer, and interface from the workgroup node to show that Credential Manager is working. Additional information can be found in KB01457, using Windows Credential Manager with PI applications. In this video, we will be linking local accounts on the interface node to low-privileged destination domain accounts. Note that the KB also describes an alternate approach of using different local accounts on both the interface node and the PI Data Archive node, and linking them with Windows Credential Manager. The approach of using two identical local accounts on the interface and PI Data Archive node should be avoided. Let's take a look at some details of our environment. On the PI School domain, we have our two service accounts, SVC PI Buffer and SVC PI Interface, and Student01 user accounts with their domain passwords. These service accounts are used across the domain for other interface nodes that are connecting to the PI Data Archive. The two service accounts have been provided minimum permissions needed on the archive through PI mappings, and Student01 is mapped to PI admins. On our workgroup interface node, PIINT02, we are currently logged in as interface local admin using the password of that local account. The interface is running as a local account, PI OPC interface, and the buffer is running as local account, PI buffer, and we'll take a look at that in just a second. Again, we had to use the local passwords for the workgroup node to set up these services. We've already set up the interface in PI buffer, but have disabled the trust in the PI data archive that was used during that setup. Also, note that the interface node does have API for Windows Integrated Security installed, so we will be able to use a mapping for API connections such as the PI OPC interface. Let's start by going over to the interface node and confirm the local service accounts. Let's go into services. And you can see that PI Buffer Subsystem is set up using a local service account, PI Buffer. And OPC interface is set up using a local account, PI OPC interface. However, neither of the two services are currently running. Let's now go ahead and open ICU. Since we're logged in as interface local admin, ICU will be running under those credentials. When it tries to connect to the PI Data Archive, it will also use those credentials. Since they're off the domain, the PI Data Archive will not understand who we are and will get a security error as shown here. As an example to what these types of errors can look like on the PI Data Archive node, let's head on over to that node on the domain and open up System Management Tools. Let's go to Operation Message Logs, and let's load the last 5 minutes of logs. And you can see here that there is an attempted connection from ICU. It is from IP address 0.06, which is our workgroup node. And you can see here that the attempted connection is for hostname PIINT02, and the account is interface local admin. Since this is off the domain, the PI Data Archive does not understand what this credential is, so we cannot create a mapping, and therefore there will be an unsuccessful login. As you can see, we had an unsuccessful login, since there are no credentials currently stored in Windows Credential Manager. Let's set up our first credential in Windows Credential Manager, linking the local interface local admin account to the domain student01 account. To do that, let's go over to PIN 02. Since we're currently logged in as interface local admin, and we'd like to link that account to a domain account, we can directly open Credential Manager. Go to Windows Credentials, add a Windows credential. We would like to connect to PISRV01, so we'll type in PISRV01.pyschool.int. And the user that we would like to link to our local admin account is the student01 account on the PySchool domain. And the password is the domain account for student01. And you can see here that there is a stored credential for student01 on the PySchool domain connecting to PISRV01 on the PySchool domain with the associated domain password. Let's close ICU and try and reconnect. And you can see now that there is a successful connection, and we can go ahead and see our OPC interface in ICU. Let's take a look at PISRV01. Let's refresh our message logs. And we can see here that there is a successful login from ICU. But the user that it sees on this side, on the domain, is the domain credential, student01 account for the PySchool domain, even though we're logged into the workgroup machine as interface local admin. Let's take a look at our mappings and security. And we can see here that student01 is mapped to PI admins, and that we have these two domain service accounts mapped to two identities, PI buffers and PI interfaces. What we need to do next is link our PI buffer local account to svc-pibuffer on the domain, and also link PI OPC local account to svc PI interface on the domain. Let's head on over to PIN 02, and we'll open the message logs. Let's go ahead and start PI Buffer Subsystem, just to take a look at the failed connection information. And you can see here that there is an error connecting to PISRV01 for PI Buffer Subsystem. No access secure object. Let's try the same for the OPC interface. And you can see here that there is also an error connecting for the OPC interface. Let's go ahead and stop our services and set up the links through Credential Manager. Stop the interface and stop Buffer Subsystem. Now, last time when we wanted to link our local admin account to a domain account, we opened Credential Manager directly from the UI. However, this time we want to link PI Buffer. And to do that, we're going to have to use command line. So first thing we'll do is we'll open the command line, and then we want to run the command line as that user. To do that, let's type in run as /user. And let's do this first for PIBuffer. Again, this is the local account PIBuffer on the workgroup node. And then we want to run command line. And you can see here that it's asking for the password. This is the local buffer account password. Okay, and we get a new command line, and it says at the top, running as PIN 02 user PIBuffer. Also, we can type in who am I, and it'll go ahead and show us who this command line is running as. The next thing we'd like to do is add a credential for this user. And the command that we use is CMDKEY. And if you type in CMDKEY -?, we can take a look at some of the options that we have for this command. We'll, of course, be using the add feature here to create a domain credential or a linkage to a domain credential for this user. But we can also list the current credentials and if needed, we can delete the credentials. So let's go ahead and start by listing the credentials to show that there aren't any. For this user, you can see that there are no stored credentials for PIBuffer. Let's go ahead and add a credential. We're going to use the same three commands or three inputs that we needed when we did it for interface local admin. So we'll type in CMDKEY, and the first thing is the target name. That again is pisrv01.pischool.int. Then we need the username of the domain account that we want to link to the local account. That will be pischool/svc-pibuffer, the domain account. And finally, we need the password to be stored locally. And that credential was added successfully. And let's go ahead and list it. And you can see here that for user pint02 PIBuffer running locally in the workgroup, there is now a stored credential for target PISRV01 on the PISchool domain with its associated domain password, and the user is the PISchool domain svc-pibuffer user. Let's do the same now for the PIOPC interface local user that we're running the OPC interface as. Again, we'll need to run command line as that user. As an alternate approach, if the command line is already running, I'm going to right-click, hold Shift, and then right-click on the command prompt here. And in some versions of Windows, you'll get run as different user. Here, we want to run the command line again for the local workgroup pint02, but we want to run for PI OPC interface. And again, this is the local PI OPC interface user's password. And in this case, it doesn't show at the top who the local user is, but what I can do is again type in who am I, and I can see that I'm running the command line as PI OPC interface. I'm going to check if I have any stored credentials, which I do not, and then I'm going to add a credential which links the local PI OPC interface account to svc-pi interface on the domain. So I type in CMDKEY, add, and my target name is pisrv01.pischool.int. My user is on the PISchool domain, and it's svc-pi interface. And I need to store the local password, store the domain password locally. This is the password for the domain account. And if I do CMDKEY list, you can see that for pint02 PIOPC interface, we now have a credential stored with a target of PISRV01 on the PISchool int domain, storing the domain password locally. And this is for the PISchool svc-pi interface account. Let's go ahead and take a look at the message logs, and let's start PIBuffer subsystem. And we can see here that we have a successful connection to the PIDATA archive. Let's also start our OPC interface. We can see that the startup got a lot further than last time. And we can see here that we are connected to the server. Let's go ahead and head on over to System Management Tools, and let's take a look at the message logs and see how we're connecting for these two services. First off, we have a new connection from PIBuffer subsystem. Again, it's coming from IP address .06, which is our workgroup machine, but now it's coming through as a domain account, svc-pibuffer. Even though it's running as a local account on the workgroup machine. We can see the same thing for our OPC interface. It's coming through as PISchool SVC PI interface, which gives it the mapping, even though it is running as a local account on the interface machine. If we take a look at Network Manager statistics, I'll hit refresh. I'll sort by IP address. And we can see that there are three connections coming from IP address .6. There's ICU, PI Buffer Subsystem, and our OPC interface. And if we go ahead and take a look over here, we can see that they are coming through as student01 getting PI admins, svc-pibuffer getting PI buffers, and svc-pi-interface getting PI interfaces. Even though they're all running as local accounts on the workgroup, they all now have individual credentials in Windows Credential Manager. A few additional notes. If you are currently connecting to the PI Data Archive from a workgroup machine using a trust, and you disable this trust and set up Windows Credential Manager, please be sure to restart your services to reauthenticate to the PI Data Archive and ensure that they are coming through using the appropriate mappings and identities. If you do not restart, they may continue to use the existing trust, even though it has been removed, until there is a reconnection to the PI Data Archive. Also, passwords stored in the Credential Manager are not updated when domain passwords are changed. For service accounts, this is usually not an issue because service accounts often have passwords that do not expire. However, for user accounts, such as student01, the password may end up changing on the domain, but it would not be updated in Windows Credential Manager. So the next time interface local admin logs into the workgroup machine, they will not be able to load ICU and will need to update the password in Windows Credential Manager. Now that you know how to link domain credentials to local accounts on workgroup machines, you can take greater advantage of the security benefits of using Windows Integrated Security.